Scientific artwork is translating a scientific content into a visual, approachable, and easy to understand concept.
Any kind of art, design, illustration, which helps communicate science in the best way possible.
Ideally works on all different communication channels, is made for a certain audience, and is easy to understand.
Think of like an illustration you look at and you only have 2 seconds to look at it and you look away and you still got the key message. That's a good scientific illustration.
There are all different kinds of scientific illustrations based on hand drawing, pixel-based, vector-based. Everything which helps to make the content, the scientific content, approachable is good. We use for 2D illustrations mainly Adobe Illustrator, Affinity and Inkscape.
Illustrator is vector-based, and vector-based literally just means they're not pixel-based and you can scale them up as much as you want to.
The most important information is that you have in mind whatever tool you're using. You use a file format which works across all platforms. When you create a visual artwork, make sure that you understood the visual concept. It helps to summarize the concept in 1 or 2 sentences to basically find a storyline.
I would define a concept in 3 steps. So basically, you first think about who you're talking to, then what you want to say, the key message, and then how you're going to say it. So these are the 3 key things in the concept, and the concept is key where you start. Meaning, if it's peers in your own group, you can use a very complex language, that's words, but that's also the graphical elements you use. But if you talk to the public, for example, you have to decrease the complexity and you have to increase the context.
Once the concept is approved, start sketching by hand and ideally test with some colleagues if the concept and the illustration is well understood.
I would draw first. And I would limit myself to a maximum of 3 colors just to be clear on actually thinking about the concept rather than making it pretty first. And if you then have in your drawing answered all the questions you had, then I would move on to a digital program like, for example, Illustrator.
The colors in a graphical abstract should be applied coherent, distinct and subtle. Ideally, the colors in the graphical abstract match the colors in the scientific paper.
I would be still really careful of how many colors you use, because they can just clutter things up and not help your story. But if you limit it yourself in the beginning in the concept, you're more likely to succeed also in the final illustration, because you've already done your illustration and it works with only 3 colors.